Looking for an ultra simple approval system? Here's how you could create inline approvals with JSON formatting. This is a cool solution you definitely need to know about. Watch until the end because I'm going to show you how to make this thing work, how it all works, and I'm going to talk about how this will affect traditional approvals in SharePoint and Power Platform. Let's get into it. So I've got a basic list here. There's really nothing special about it. I just created it straight from site contents. Now we need to just populate our columns to make this thing work. The first thing we're going to do is add in a calculated column. Now we don't actually need a formula for this thing, but we do need a place to put our formatter. And so a calculated column will work fine. You could use a single line of text as well, and that'll be fine. The column name is going to be approval. It'll be calculated for our example. We don't really want a formula, but we have to put something in here. So you could just put an equal sign and then two quotes, and that'll be fine. We'll leave the column formatting blank for now because we're going to go back in to apply that. And next, we need to add in our approval status. That's going to be a choice column, and we'll call this approval action. Actually, that's going to be item status. And it'll be a choice column will be pending, approved, and rejected. Those are the three statuses we need to set here. Well, the default value is going to be pending, and all of that should be good. We will click save here. And then we need to know who approved or rejected this. We want to track that. So we're going to add in a person column, and this will be approved action by. We're going to get rid of the spaces for now. We can add them back in afterwards. That way it looks good, but then internally it's a nice clean name. And most importantly, the formatter is going to be referencing this particular name without the spaces. It'll be a person or a group. We do not want multiple selections or groups. We will just click save right here. And then we can actually go back in, edit the column, and we can add our spaces in. And the same with item status, we can change this to, how about approval status? Call that approval status. And maybe let's move approval over here at the end. I think that'll be fine. So now we need to copy the data in here. So I'll go ahead and do that. All right, so now we've got some items in here, and you see the approval status automatically got set to pending for all of these. So now we need to copy in our JSON formatter. So for that, we're going to go click the down arrow for the approval column, and we're going to go select format this column, go down to advanced mode, because we're not going to do the conditional formatting. We've got a custom one we'll be copying in here. Expand this out so we can see what we're doing, and we'll delete this. And then I'm gonna copy in the formatter. Now I will show you in just a little bit where I got this from, and then even show you how to read this thing, what this thing actually does. But first, let's get this thing copied in here. We can hit preview. That looks good. Let's save this and close it. So what are we looking at now? Now we're gonna test to see how this thing actually works. But first, if you're enjoying this content, click that like button and subscribe to this channel to let me know. It'll also tell YouTube that you wanna see more of these types of solution demos as I create them. So what we've got here is we've got an approve and reject button for all of these items. If someone comes in here and they click the approve button, look at what happened. So our approval status just changed to this item's approved. Our approval action, it's set to me because I'm the one who clicked that button. And our approval status is set to approved. So just like that, you have all these different fields that are all getting values set. If I click reject, same thing. You have all of this that is being maintained automatically so that it's easy. It's really easy to use, right? Someone can come in here and approve or reject. Now we'll talk about the implications of this versus Power Automate as well. We're going to cover that. But first, we've got this thing and we need to see, like, what is this thing actually doing? So let's jump into the actual formatter and see what this thing does. But first, if you haven't noticed this new list interface that we're getting, I think it started in Microsoft List, but it's in definitely in SharePoint now. And if you create new lists, you should be seeing this new thing where we've got the ability to, we've got extra stuff in this list interface. It definitely looks a lot cleaner. And if you want to stay up to date with the various SharePoint developments that come out, all the news, I've actually got a SharePoint Insights newsletter that would be perfect for you. It's once a week. It doesn't take much time, maybe a few minutes to kind of read through this thing. Keeps you up to date on all the news in the world of SharePoint. You'll find a link in the description below. Now let's jump into this formatter. Let's go all the way to the top. Let's talk through this thing, because all this really is, it may look fancy, all it's really doing is putting HTML and CSS on the page. That's really it. There's some rules that you follow with JSON, but it really isn't as bad as it looks. So we're going to be creating a div, an HTML div, to house all of our stuff. So everything is going to be in like one container. We'll set a little bit of CSS to control how things are going to be displayed on the page, how it's going to flow in its little box. Then we're going to be setting the item status. We're going to create a div inside that, and it's going to set the item. It's going to check the item status, actually. So it's checking this field right here, the item status. And if it's set to pending, or if it's not set to anything, then it's going to be showing the contents, because that's how we get our approval button. If there's no item status, if there's no approval status, then it needs to be showing something, approve or reject. But if it's the status is approved, if the status is rejected, we've already taken action on this item, and so we just do nothing. That's where this none comes into play. This is going to hide it. That's why when we look at the items that we've already approved and rejected, we don't see those buttons. This div is hidden so that we can display other stuff instead. Again, a few more items down here to do the alignment and wrapping any text or wrapping any other containers inside here. We've got buttons here that we're going to start defining. That's our approve or reject. That's how we have the interaction ability with those buttons. And when that button is clicked in this particular one, it's going to set a value. We see that with this custom row action. The custom row action lets you add some of that kind of interaction ability to this. So in this case, we're going to be passing in a couple of things. We're going to set item status to approved, and we're going to set the approval action by, which is our other column right here. We're going to set that to the at me special string. So in whoever's visiting it, that at me is going to represent that particular user. So that's how it knew to assign me to this. If you were to go into my list and click approve or reject, it would show your username instead, or your display name. So that's kind of a neat trick. We're able to set two different fields at the same time just with one button click. There's some attributes here where we can set the themes, which is really cool. So if the themes change, if you change the colors, all of that will get reflected. So instead of purple, like we see here, which as you notice, it matches the add new item button. That's all part of the theme color. So this inherits the theme colors by using this method. And again, this may look really complex and you may be thinking, hey, Steve, I'm not a coder. I get it. You don't have to be a developer though. I actually created an online course to teach you how this all works. If you're interested, I've got a link in the description, but let's keep going through this and you'll see how the rest of it works. So we are finishing up this initial button here. We have inside here, we're gonna actually define the stuff that's in this button. You'll see the little Skype circle check icon name. That's how we have this check mark. And we have the text content approved. So that's where the approve comes from right here. And each of these are in their own little container here. So that this whole thing is our first little button on here. Then we've got our reject button. We'll see the exact same behavior as before, as was with the approve button. So we're creating a button. We're using custom row action so that we could set a value. And then we're just changing the values we're passing to SharePoint. Instead of approved, we're telling it that the item status is now rejected. The approval action by, that's still me, because I'm the one, or whoever's clicking that button is the approver or rejecter. We have our themes that we're applying, our various other CSS class properties. So if you wanted it larger or smaller, you know, you could adjust the sizing, you could adjust tons and tons of stuff in here to get it to look just the way you want it to look. And then, you know, we'll see our icon name. We'll see blocked, which is that little no symbol there. And then the word reject. So there's our two reject, there's our two buttons, approve and reject. It's all handled right here. Then we move on to the next thing. Now, all of that was either going to be shown if the status was pending or if there wasn't a status at all. If the item status is pending or if there isn't a status, instead of the inherit like we had before, now it's none. Otherwise, we are going to inherit, which is normally just showing the item. So it's the reverse logic. All we really did was the none and the inherit were swapped in this case. So one's going to be shown or the other's going to be shown, but never at the same time because it just wouldn't make sense in our scenario. And then other than that, we have our text content. So this is the text that you're actually seeing where it says this item is, and then it just converts everything to lowercase, whatever's an item status. And so it's this item is approved or this item is rejected. We see that with our first three items. Pretty simple. This is definitely one of the more simple solutions, but it does show some really kind of fun things that you can do. You see the custom row action so that we can do stuff with our data, do stuff to other columns, set values and things like that, which can definitely speed things up. We've also, where you're also seeing the themes being applied so that this looks like it came straight out of the box from SharePoint. It fits in, it matches all the branding. If you change the theme, everything is going to be reflected, including this custom solution. So the question you're asking now is, how is this going to affect the Power Automate approvals? That's what we're supposed to use, right? So will this replace traditional approvals? Well, if you don't need a formal approval process, then yeah, why not? It's simple, it doesn't require knowledge of Power Automate, and it's fast to set up. If you need to make sure approvals are only done by certain people though, or you've got a complex approval process, then no, Power Automate is the way to go. So here's where the solution came from. It is just called approval buttons set value status user, which is a little bit odd of a name, but again, you'll have a link to this. You'll see a little bit of a summary of what this thing does, as well as a demo image, which is common for a lot of these samples in the PNP GitHub repository. You'll see any view requirements, which in our case were the three columns that we set up, and you'll see information about the author, themselves. You can go up here to the JSON file, and you'll be able to see all that stuff that we just covered. It's also the stuff we copied into our JSON formatting window. But you can select all here and copy, or you could just click this button right here that says copy raw file, and it's even easier. So there's a link in the description to get you started with this solution if you want to try it out in your environment. And if you want to see all the other solutions that I've been covering, click or tap the screen to get started.